minutes, and we'll just break out outside for the written press. First question.
After such a strong standing there last year, after two bad results in a row, have you blown?
Absolutely not. No, we can win our last two games. We can still make it. No doubt, mate, after a performance like that tonight, I'm very confident that we can win both games.
Martin, did you feel that Daryl Murphy deserved a penalty awarded the last few months? And the referee just not give us a break that we deserve?
Well, I just on the TV interviews, I didn't see it by the players are absolutely adamant that it was a penalty kick. I've not seen it by here, I've just come out here, and the players in the dressing rooms are saying that it's a clear cut penalty. And the referee has chosen to not to do it.
Okay, questions, guys, please.
Just your take on the group now. You said we can still qualify for second place. Wales can still be Georgia as well, so there's still a bit to play for. And is that your message to the players? Don't give up on us now?
Oh, very much so. I'd say that to them in the dressing room. Obviously, a lot of disappointed players in there, particularly after the performance. And it's not just big words, it's how I feel. I think that we can win both games, and that's what we have to do.
Martin, you must have been pleased with the response from the press. You took a lot of criticism the other night.
I thought the players were fantastic tonight. Really, really fantastic. I thought they gave every ounce for the show tonight. Every single ounce that they had. They did nothing like that. And it was a big, big effort. As Philip has just mentioned, if we had got just desserts, penalty kick and maybe a possible conversion, it would have been the least we deserved in the game tonight. I don't colour off a score, a rocket of a goal, I must admit. I don't remember them threatening us three times in the game. And apparently their captain said it's the toughest game he's played at international level.
Martin, obviously you started David Meyler, had a Glenn Whelan tonight. You got man of the match from RT and everything like that. Is that something we're going to see again in the future? Is David now in contention to be selected ahead of Glenn on a regular basis?
Well, first of all, Glenn's getting a little bit older, you don't mind me saying that. Two games in quick succession, a few days and a long, long trip back. And we freshened up. David played exceptionally well tonight. I'm delighted for him. Absolutely delighted. I thought that Wes did very well as well too. I thought that if he lasted the half, that would be great for us. We saw out to about 60 minutes, which was fantastic. And I thought that he, getting on the ball here, helped us try and create a few things. I thought Milo was exceptional, particularly in the first half. He's just come into the game, commanded the situation, and there was a period of 15 minutes where he was absolutely excellent. I think that the players, no matter what age they are, they enjoy playing. And when Wes is 35 years of age, and so they love playing. And we'll see. But it was a great effort by Meyler tonight, and a great effort by the team.
Martin, at the start of this group, were you taking off the win by itself?
Well, obviously we have to beat Moldova. I think that they were up until the 81 minutes or something, I got 0-0 against it. We have to win. I think we've lost James and Robbie. So we lost Robbie as well.
Yeah.
Two big players for us for that night. But if you're asking me, before a ball was kicked, if you'd said to me that you seriously had to win the last two games, one at home, one away in Cardiff to make the playoffs, I would definitely have taken it. And I am right. That is the situation, isn't it? We can. 19 points can get in
it. Are you more disappointed tonight than you were on Saturday?
I'm disappointed for the team. And I'll tell you who I'm really disappointed for, and he didn't even play tonight. That's our captain in the side. I'm talking about Seamus Coleman. And Seamus was... the players were delighted to see him coming over. I was delighted to see him come. high praise for a world-class player, and if we could make it to the World Cup, I think he might come back around about Christmas time. I think if the players, who love him to death anyway, if there's anything that can keep you going, it would be that for Coleman to make it to the World Cup.
Mark, could I just ask you about how much of a concern is it that just the lack of a clinical edge in attack in games like this?
You will be a better judge than me in this year. That's been a situation that the Republic of Ireland had for 40 odd years, perhaps. And that is the case. I think Roy Keane was telling me that even with the great side that they possessed under John Child, they were never running away with games. And so is the case. These games are tight. We have to be the side that scores the decisive goal. On a lot of occasions in the last couple of years, we have been that. Now we have two games to try and pull that ground. We need to find the net, and we need to win. But I take your point entirely. It's that clinical finish. Unfortunately, for my tenure here, I had an aging Robbie Keane. I think about that, that the 27-year-old Robbie Keane would be in his element tonight.
Well, they asked you, you had Daryl Morgan on bench tonight. It sounds like we had two very large years in the first place to play against that previous last year that you all saw.
I brought on a substitute that nearly won the game for us, nearly got the goal at the start. And we had as many creative players on the field as we could possibly do. That's what we were going for at the end. Daryl Horton is just coming into the squad. He's just made his way over to Preston. Unfortunately, he's not playing regularly in Preston's side at this moment. And it's that lack of game time, perhaps, maybe that was only concern. I've got a lot of time for Daryl Horton, both as a player and as a person. I think he's great. His attitude around the training ground is absolutely first class. He wants to be part of the team, and he's prepared to win. And he wants to, as I say, he wants to, I think, establish himself as much as possible in the championship, and then feel as if he's ready to win. That's the point. He played a game for us in the United States, and perhaps maybe it wasn't his best game.
Martin, you mentioned already just about creativity, and how maybe it's always been a bit of an issue. Tonight, there was a lot of time to be pressure on them. There was the opportunity to play a good fine ball or a fine ball. Is there any reason why there was maybe a lack of composure that fine ball didn't quite happen? Is there anything you put your finger on?
No, I also take your point. I think that one of the distinguishing features about really, really top class sides is the ability to pick A, a pass out under pressure, B, to deal with it. And tonight, in the last 7 or 8 minutes, I know that we were going for it, but you have to play with your head. James and Delphi had a right foot shot at the edge of the box, Conor Urans, who's essentially left with it, had a left foot shot, but also a right foot shot. You've got to keep that ball alive. This is really, really important. Shane Long has played a ball on that edge about 7 or 8 minutes to go. He's played it to think that somebody's there, but it's just not. These are very, very, very important moments. And that distinguishes the really great sides with the sides who are able to deal with those situations. Or when you need a wee bit of width again just to try and create something, put the ball in the penalty box. And as you just said, excuse me, that I have not seen it back.
Meyler, absolutely adamant, sort of said that, that we should have a family king. This sort of things change, we do. But I take your point entirely. This is very important to be able to play under that sort of pressure and choose the right pass, the right moment for the right delivery.
Can I ask, what was your read on the goal? It was a fantastic finish, but maybe Colorado had a lot more time to play than it would like.
Well, it's going to happen. They are very good players. We you told me that we would limit them to as little during the course of the game as they did. Eventually, I would have settled for that. We chased, we hurried, we played, we got it down to try and play it as well too, obviously. And there are moments in the game when class players who are playing in the big leagues, can come and create something. And he got a bit of space to play in, and he's hammered it into the net. And that's proved the difference in the game.
Okay, thank you. We'll take a break out of here.